Is point of order, Dr. Russel Norman.
I seek leave to table the document showing where Ministry for the Environment says that 57% of monitored swimming spots had water quality that met the requirements almost all the time.
Leave is sought to table that document. Is there any objection? There is no objection. Point of order, the Honourable Tribunal.
Mr. Speaker, I thought that Russel Norman was going to take it again as the, I think, the third time today, a question of gratuitous comments, totally irrelevant in this case, by the Prime Minister. And whether or not, sir, we've, at your advice, we've worked quite hard on this side of the House, not always successfully, but to
order.
Shut up.
Order, no, order. Order. I don't want to ask the member to resume his seat. That's unfair to the Honourable Member. Please, I ask the House to please show some courtesy to a colleague. The Honourable Trevor Knight.
Mr Speaker, the point is that you have given the House advice, and members on this side of the House have been making a real attempt to follow it as to staying within standing orders. And I think it's generally accepted there's been a lot of progress in that over the last year or so, sir. It's just a question of whether the same advice is going to the Prime Minister. Because, sir, if we three times made that sort of gratuitous comment or had interrupted you on your feet in the way that the Prime Minister had, we would have gone.
Well, the member was doing pretty well till that point. The member will have noted that today I was not very happy with, indeed, the Prime Minister at one stage, but it was my assessment that it would have been unfair to the opposition to have actually asked the Prime Minister to leave the House, because there are at least several questions to the Prime Minister that I'm sure the opposition wanted to have him answer and not anyone else. So the Speaker has to make all sorts of judgments at a time. But I just don't want to be too unreasonable. I mean, so long as there's a little bit of humour in some comments, to me, I don't want to be too unreasonable. The member says that the opposition, the Labour Party, has tried to get their questions much tighter, and I think many members have indeed, and I congratulate members on that. But I just invite them to reflect, many questions still seek opinions. And where opinions are sought, that particular question asked the Prime Minister about risks. Now, the Prime Minister, in answering it, okay, he shared a risk with the questioner that maybe was a bit flippant, but if I were to try and prevent that kind of comment, I think we'd almost destroy question time, and it's the kind of risk there is when a questioner asks a minister about risks. They may get included in risks they see, something they didn't expect. And that's my dilemma as Speaker. I just don't want to be too unrealistic. But members will note that where a straight question is asked, seeking information, I'm pretty tough on ministers. Where questions contain seek opinions, it's much more difficult for me. Where supplementary questions contain statements, alleged statements of fact, it's much more difficult for me. But I hear the member's point, and I'll do my best to achieve what he's seeking, but I don't want to destroy any humour at all. And in that particular case, I say the question asked about risks, and a risk was included that was perhaps not totally what was expected, but I don't want to rule out that sort of thing completely. Question number 7, Nikki Wagner.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. To the Minister of Education.